We're in a camp that is between the Syrian capital of Damascus and the border with Jordan. But most of the people here who've arrived since March have come from a suburb north of Damascus called Eastern Ghouta. That was a major opposition stronghold, and the Syrian government launched a major offensive against rebel groups there in recent months. And you might remember the ferocity of that bombardment. So many of the kids that we've talked to in the camp, as you might imagine, are quite traumatized by that time, the sounds that they heard, the bombing, and of course years of living under siege. We met one woman, for example, who told us that she lost her one-year-old baby simply because she couldn't exit the area she was living in because of the fighting, because sometimes rebels wouldn't let them out. So it gives you a sense of the kind of pressures and traumas that people here have been living with. And in the camp you'll find people who supported the rebels and those who were opposed to them. But the bottom line is that all of the people here are under the control of the Syrian government. You can't come freely in and out of the camp. And young men, for example, who haven't fulfilled their military service, there is conscription here during wartime, they will be tagged to sign up for the military if they haven't done so before now. The other interesting thing about this camp, though, is it's very close to a place called Kizwe, which is where the Israelis struck an Iranian facility, they say an Iranian facility, earlier this week. And people here also say they heard the major barrage of Israeli missiles early yesterday morning. They say that their houses shook. It gives you a sense for them of the war not being over. They don't have a lot of radios or televisions to watch the news, but they do know what's happening. They say they don't want to see the war escalate. They're worried about anything that seeks or speaks to a prolongation of the war. They say they simply want to have their lives back. Margaret Evans, CBC News, south of Damascus.